Hey, welcome again, guys. This is an amazing reshape short clip we've put together with one of our amazing speakers. Joining us today is Johannes Reck from Get Your Guide. He's a co-founder and CEO of the brilliant brand company and travel. What is it now? You guys are almost everywhere, right? Your app is being used everywhere.
Yeah, absolutely. Our app now is used by more than 40 million customers around the world, with a very heavy footprint in the United States and Europe.
Wow. So let's start with this. Reshape is about the experience code. Now, the question is, what is the customer experience, the experience that you're looking to have, like? What is it that you were striving to do, especially during these few months, like the last 18 to 20 months?
Our principle was that we want to come out as a better company for our customers after the pandemic that we went into. And that meant that we put a lot of investment dollars into our long-term bets on the platform. And that's most notably our core search experience. How can companies discover and experience the world's most exciting things to do anywhere where they go, whether that's around their home and their backyard and more domestic travel, or whether that's their first international trip that they do after this pandemic. So very much along the lines of how can we improve the technical infrastructure and the search experience and the fulfillment experience, as well as what's our inventory footprint like, both internationally as well as around customers' homes? And we've invested a lot in that. And I do feel we're now in a actually much better spot than before the pandemic, which is exciting for when people come back and travel again.
Awesome. And what do you contribute this bounce back to? Is it more and more people now being vaccinated? Is there another underlying factor we are not thinking about?
I think it's a combination of low COVID cases now in our core geographies in Europe and in the United States, as well as vaccinations both. We did see a pretty steep bounce back also last summer when no one was vaccinated yet, just when the lockdowns ended and people could travel again. Because customers, fundamentally, you can't lock them up. They really seek to have these incredible experiences when they travel. They want to go out, and every time quarantine measures and anytime lockdowns, and we see an immediate boost in our numbers. And now the exciting piece is that compared to like previous spikes, this one now looks like it's going to stay every week. We see more and more activities and more geos, and nothing has gone back yet, which also from a vaccination point of view makes a lot of sense. I do think we're now slowly but certainly pulling out of the pandemic and getting back to normal, and it's just let me tell you, so much pent-up demand now for booking travel and experiences.
Completely understand that. Now touching upon a lot of what I hear on the news, you can hear a lot of people talking about responsible traveling, which is get your vaccines so that you're able to travel, but you're also being sure that you're trying to be kind of in your space responsible, because you're responsible for yourself and then those around you. And because you're a biochemistry major, I'm asking you this question. Are there any particular types of vaccines that you have seen people take a lot of, which keeps them now a bit more relaxed and say, yeah, you know what, now I can travel?
Yeah, I have, obviously in Germany, seen a lot of people take BioNTech, which is a German vaccine. I personally vaccinated with BioNTech as well, and it was a good experience. It has very high efficiency, and so far, it is fully capable of preventing severe disease, also against any types of mutants. Based on my information and insights, I would say that is also likely to stay for quite a while. And so it's definitely one of the top vaccines. I do think Moderna, AstraZeneca, and the other ones are also quite good. In my immediate environment at the company, we've had people taking all vaccines, and so far none of the people who were vaccinated got infected or reinfected. So I do think the vaccine overall, and that's also what the numbers clearly tell us in Germany, we're now almost COVID-free, ultimately the vaccines are the way out of the pandemic.
Knock on wood, hopefully we're getting to a point where COVID is going to be not maybe a distant memory, but at least a near short-term memory. When you think of a bounce back, do you have a prediction of when we are at least going to see a lot more, if not, I don't mean the 20% of international travel, but more of the, let's say, 50 to 60% international travel coming back again. Do you see that happening this year in 2021?
So we see a tremendous bounce back already on regional and domestic travel. We are way above pre-pandemic numbers in all of our major geos in domestic. You know, to give you an example, in the US, we are more than 4x our pre-pandemic domestic travel numbers. I mean, that's pretty strong growth coming out of nowhere in January this year. And in international travel, I do think, it will come back more than we initially thought this year. So I do think we'll have maybe a comeback of like 10, 20% of pre-COVID international travel numbers this year. I do think the real push is going to happen next year, frankly, because we will need to have more of the world being vaccinated before we can do it. We do need to have more functional COVID passports. So, you've either been infected, tested, or, you've had the vaccine and, or a combination of the two. And, that needs to be fully implemented. Quarantine measures need to be lifted. That's really on people's mind when they travel right now. And, that's also the key reason why they don't want to travel. And, some major corridors like US and Europe haven't even fully reopened yet, right? So all of that now, needs to happen. And I do think, in reality, this is rather going to be Q1, next year, that it's really coming back than any time before that. I think this year will still be very carefully and measured travel and, to regional or domestic destinations.
Brilliant. And coming back to Reshape, because you definitely are joining us at Reshape, there is this amazing travel program we've created for the travel and hospitality industry, especially. Why is it you joined Reshape? What was some of the motivations that you had when you were joining Reshape?
I think, for us, we've been very internally focused throughout the pandemic, and we've determined that it is actually now the time to tell the story of, what we've done in the pandemic, how we've survived and how we're thriving now. Because it's quite remarkable. I think it's a very European story in that, it's been about, how can we as a company move through this together, as one entity, as one, group of like highly motivated people, how can we find very creative solutions to a very complex problem, and then reemerge, as a champion globally, not just in our home market, and as a better and stronger company. And I found that, Reshape was just a great forum to tell that story.
Thank you. And last question, what are the two words that define Reshape to you?
Community and innovation.
Thank you. That I think that talks very largely to our amazing speakers, the community we've been creating, the community we've got with our attendees, the delegates who we have at Reshape, and we are very lucky to have, and of course the innovation each of you leaders are now bringing to the plate. Thank you so much for having us, Johannes, and I hope to catch you at Reshape next.
Perfect. See you at Reshape. Thank you so much.
Cheers, guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.